Hey, what's up guys, I'm Dunes from my Geeks blog and I'm back with another round of tips to make your iOS and macOS life easier. In earlier video, I explained about some must-do settings on your iPhone. And you can find the link of the video from the description area. This time, I will show you some Mac settings you should change right away. So just stay tuned with me till end of this video. And very first settings on the list is hot corners. To briefly explain, four corners of your Mac screen can be used for quick actions. You just need to take mouse cursor in respective corner of the screen for quick access to certain things. Let's see how to use it. Head over to System Preferences, Desktop and Screensaver. Now click on Screensaver tab and then click on Hot Corners button at the bottom right. On the next screen beside corner options, there is a drop-down list of available options. Select the one you use the most and set up another corner similarly. Just to let you know, I have set Launchpad on the top right corner, Notifications on the bottom right, Desktop on the bottom left, and Dashboard on the top left corner of my display. These four things are used frequently on my Mac and hot corners makes it quicker to access. The second most handy settings is the Finder app. You may have noticed that when you open Finder, it opens the recent folders by default. Let's change the folder to something else, some folder that you use the most. Open the Finder app and go to Finder Preferences. Click on the General tab. This one is my favorite settings. I have changed the recent options in New Finder window so to Download Folders, because that is the folder I use the most. You should change it to whatever folder you check frequently. Now click on Sidebar tab. Here you can customize what all things you wish to see in Finder sidebar. Make sure you keep only folders or drives that you frequently use. That will make your Finder clutter-free and also get you your destination quickly. If you wish to do advanced configurations, click on the Advanced tab. Here you can customize different options like seeing file name extensions, emptying trash after 30 days, and some other handy things. Just play around it and make changes whenever you require. The menu bar on the Mac offers quick access to most of the frequently used features like dead end time, Bluetooth, volume control, and many other nifty things. If you are missing any of the icon on the menu bar, it is pretty easy to get it. Head over to System Preferences, then Sound, and check the box that says so in menu bar. Repeat the steps for dead end time and Bluetooth. Another little settings you should be doing is to show battery percentage. To do so, click on the battery icon on the menu bar and then click on show percentage. Apart from adding icons, you can also rearrange them in a particular order. To do so, press and hold the command key on the keyboard and move your cursor over the menu bar. When holding the command key, click and move the icon in the desired order. If you drag and drop the icon from menu bar to desktop, it will be removed. Tag is one of the handy ways to organize your files and folders. It allows you to quickly access files and folders that you are looking for. By default, the tag categories on Mac is defined by different colors, which becomes hard to remember. Thankfully, you can name these tags the way you want. To do so, open the Finder app, head over to Finder Preferences and select Tags. You can see that tags are named as colors. Select the tag and hit Enter on the keyboard to rename. Now start typing whatever you wish to name. The tagging feature is not limited to just renaming, you can also create or delete tags. To do so, click plus button to add new tag while clicking minus to remove any existing tag. Head over to Finder and check new changes in your file system. Blue light from the display can put a lot of stress on your eyes, especially when working at nights with room lights turned off. Fortunately, Mac has a night shift options, which is different from the dark theme. Let's see how to use it up. Head over to System Preferences, then Display and select Night Shift. Here you can either manually turn on the features or schedule it. Also, you can customize warmness of the screen depending on your preferences. In fact, the Mac comes with some additional tweaks, and that's exactly what I will show you today. Head over to the System Preferences, Desktop and Screensaver. And on the Desktop tab, you can select from Dynamic, Light and Dark Themes. Dynamic will change the desktop pictures throughout the day, while the Light option uses bright wallpapers and Dark options displays night theme wallpaper. Apart from these two, there is one more theme related settings you should know. It is the Dark Mode, designed exclusively for Mojave. To use it, go to System Preferences, General and choose Dark from Appearances to use the Dark theme. I have multiple windows open on my Mac and sometimes I resize them to fit my needs. But there are times when I need to drag the windows so that I get more space for other applications. Instead of the historic way of click and drag the window, Mac offers an easy gestures based on process to move applications window. To enable it, go to System Preferences, Accessibility, Mouse and Trackpad. Now click on Trackpad option and check the box beside Enable Dragging. From the drop-down menu besides it, select 3-finger drag and click OK. Now head over to any window and use 3 fingers on trackpad to move it anywhere you like. Siri is a very helpful assistant, but what if you are at a place where talking to Siri is not possible, but at the same time you want to ask her to get a task done? Not a problem, just type to her. Go to System Preferences, Accessibility, Siri and check the box near Type to Siri. From now, whenever you call Siri, it will come with a text box where you can type your query. The new MacBook Pro is introduced with a touch bar and by all means, it is just great. On top of that, customizing it to suit personal requirement is also super easy. Let's see how to add new items to touch bar and also customize it. Head over to System Preferences, Keyboard, Customize Touch Bar. You will see many icons that can be added to touch bar. In order to add it, just click and drag it to the bottom of the screen and it will be added on the touch bar. Furthermore, you can also arrange these icons on the touch bar itself. Touch and hold the icon you wish to rearrange and then drag it to the position where you wish to place it. Last but not least, in order to remove the icon from touch bar, touch and hold the icon and then drag it all the way to the left of the touch bar and then tap on done. That was simple, isn't it? Now let's check out other settings. Choose how quickly your MacBook locks. If you happen to leave your Mac open on your desk frequently, this is the settings you should do right away, so that no one can access it while you are away. Go to System Preferences, Desktop and Screensavers, select Screensaver tab and select 1 minute. This will start the screensaver in case of inactivity for a minute. At the same time, it will lock your Mac. One of the most irritating thing is automatic app update. It is needed for some essential apps, but not for all. I prefer to update apps manually that I want. If you share the same thought, follow these steps to stop automatic app update. Launch App Store, select App Store Preferences, uncheck first two options to disable automatic app update. Now let's check out a few other settings for apps that you should do. The Mac App Store has almost all the apps that we may need. But there are many awesome apps that do not make it to the App Store, but you cannot download and install them right away. Go to System Preferences, Security and Privacy, General, unlock Security and Password Preferences to make changes and select App Store and Identified Developers. Doing this will allow you to install apps from identified developers. I'm pretty sure everyone is mostly using Google Chrome on their Mac, but there is a large group of people that prefers to use Safari as their default browser. By default, Safari doesn't show websites favicons on the tab window. These may not be critical things for most, but if you happen to open a plethora of tabs, finding the one using favicon is helpful. To enable this, open Safari, select Safari Preferences, then select Tabs, and check the box beside Show Website Icons in Tabs. Some websites have background sound, while some intuitive websites have integrated their videos as a pop-up. The most irritating thing is that they autoplay as soon as the website loads. Thankfully, Safari has an option to disable it. Let's see how to do it. Go back to Safari Preferences, select Websites, select Autoplay, and select Never Autoplay from drop-down list. Cloud storage is of utmost priority for saving important files and folders. Google Drive does a great job by allowing you to select only folders that you wish to sync in real time, while iCloud also supports it, but in a limited way. You cannot specify folders to sync. Instead, there is an option to sync desktop and documents. That means any folder on desktop or documents folders will be synced in real time. To enable it, go to System Preferences, iCloud, check the box beside iCloud Drive, and then click Options. Now check the box beside Desktop and Documents folders. That's it. All your files and folders on desktop and documents will sync with iCloud Drive as and when you make any changes. This particular setting is for users having Mac as well as Apple Watch. macOS has introduced a very handy feature to unlock your Mac with Apple Watch. Once you set up, there is no input required to unlock the Mac. You just need to sit to start work. Apple Watch will unlock the Mac for you. Let's see how to use it. Like all other settings, go to System Preferences, select Security and Privacy, make sure you are on the General tab, tick the box to allow Apple Watch to unlock the Mac. First time setup may take a minute or two. After that, you can lock your Mac and check. As we are already in the security and privacy settings, let's do one more thing here. It is about your location privacy. Don't let apps track your location unnecessarily, unless it is completely invitable to do so. With Mac, you can select which all apps can access your location. Under Security and Privacy, click the lock icon, enter password, and uncheck all the apps that you wish shouldn't access your location. Apart from privacy, this also helps you preserve some battery while you are on the go. One last setting up my sleeve is to choose where Spotlight search on Mac. Head over to Spotlight options in System Preferences and select locations where you want Spotlight to search for your queries. That's all guys, there are some of the settings that I personally use on my Mac and they have helped me. If I have missed any awesome customization, shout out in the comments. And if this video has helped you, give it thumbs up, share it and subscribe to our channel to easily access our latest hands-on guides, reviews and more. I am Dhwanesh signing off and will see you in my very next video.